Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. This is Ajay. So today we are going to learn about insertion sort. Now first we will understand how an insertion sort works theoretically using an animation, and then practically we will implement that using a Python program. Because once we implement it through a Python program, the things will work in a different way. So first let us understand this theoretically, how it works. So there are numbers in front of you. You can see there are random numbers, and now we are going to sort this using the insertion sort. And the numbers above, you can see those are the position numbers, that is number 1 to number 10. So these are the positions of those numbers. So at number 1 we have 60, at number 2 we have 56 and so on. So now the first thing in insertion sort is that we always start with the position 2, that is from the second position. Now you can see there's a second position, we have the number called as 56. So we will first take the number 56 and then we will compare it with the left hand side, that is the number 60, that is with the position 1. And since 56 is less than 60, we will shift the number 60 towards the right, one step towards the right. So you can see over there we have shifted the number 60 one place towards the right, and then we will place 56 at position 1. Now let us not get confused, we are not swapping the numbers, be very clear about it, we are not swapping the numbers, we are shifting the numbers, we are inserting the number 56 to its right position. So it is called as insertion sort. Once we complete this exercise, it will be very clear to you that we are not swapping numbers, we are shifting the numbers. So now we have placed 56 at its right position. Now we will place our pointer to the next position, that is at the position 3. At position 3 we have the number 4. So we will take this number, and this number we will compare it with the left hand side, that is with the number 60 and with number 56. Now both these numbers are greater than 4. So what we will do is we will shift 60 and 56 one position towards the right. So here we go. So we have shifted 56 and 60 one position towards the right, and then we will place 4 at number 1 position. Now we will shift the pointer to the next position, that is at the 4th position, and now at the 4th position we have the number 3. So we will take this number and compare it with the numbers at the left hand side. So first we will compare it with 60, 56 and 4. Now all these three numbers are greater than 3. So what we will do is we will shift these numbers one position at the right. So we have shifted the numbers towards the right. Every number has been shifted one position towards the right. And then we will place the number 3 at the position 1. Now the pointer will move to the next position, that is at the position 5. At position 5 we have the number 5. So we will take this number. Now we will compare this number with the left hand side, that is with the number 60, then with the number 56, with 4 and then with 3. Now the thing is 5 is lesser than 60 and 56, but it is greater than 4. So what we have to do is we have to shift 60 and 56 one position towards the right. We won't shift 3 and 4. 3 and 4 will remain at its own position. Only 56 and 60 will move towards the right. So 56 and 60 has been shifted towards the right, and after that we will place the number 5 to its right position, that is at the position 3. So we have inserted the number 5 to its right position. Now the pointer has moved to the 6th position. Now at 6th position we have the number 58. So we will compare this number with the numbers at the left hand side. So we will compare it with 60. Now 58 is less than 60. But 58 is greater than 56. So what we will do is we will only shift the 60 at the right hand side. So we have shifted 60 one position towards the right, and then we will place 58 to its right position, that is at the position 5. Now the pointer has moved to the next position, and at the next position we have the number 23. So we will take this number and compare it with the left hand side numbers. So if you see 23 is less than 60, 58 and 56. So what we will do is we'll shift these three numbers one position towards the right. There we go, and then we will place the number 23 to its right position. Now at the next position we have the number 6. So we will compare these numbers with the left hand side. So if you see number 6 is less than 60, 58, 56 and 23. So what we will do, we will shift these four numbers towards the right, and then we will place the number 6 to its right position. Now we will take the next number, that is number 24, and we will use the same technique. We will compare it with the numbers at the left hand side. So if you compare it, you will find it 56, 58 and 60. These three numbers are greater than 24. So what we will do, we will shift these positions, shift these numbers one place towards the right. Now we have shifted the numbers, and then we placed number 24 to its right position. And at last, we have the number 0. Now number 0 is at position 10. So we will take this number, and if you compare this number to the numbers at the left hand side, you will find that this number is lesser than to all the numbers that we have at the left hand side. So as simple as that, same technique, we will shift all these numbers one position towards the right. So there it is. Now if you see these numbers are sorted using the technique insertion sort. And what we have learned is the theoretical part. Now we will understand practically how to implement this using a Python program. So here it is. There is a Python program in front of you for insertion sort. And these are the same numbers that we took the example. And over here the position numbers are starting from 0 to 9. That's because we are using the list for storing the numbers, and list, the index value of the list starts from 0. So for the first thing, that is that the index position will be starting from 0. So as what we have learned in insertion sort, we will be starting from the position, the second position, and but over here it will be the first position, since the index value starts from 0. So this is the first position, the index value first, that is the number 56. And so I will directly go to the function that is doing the work for us, that is the insertion sort. And over here I've used a nested loop. The outermost loop is a for loop and the innermost loop is the while loop. Now the outermost loop, that is the for loop, it is starting from I in range 1 comma len of L. Over here L is the list, and we are starting from 1, that's the second position, that's the number 56. And then I'm storing L of I into number. So you can see over here, the variable number is having 56. The value of I will be 1 and position is 0. If you see over here, position is equal to I minus 1. So the variable position will be 0. Inside that, I'm starting a while loop and I'm comparing whether the number is less than L of position. So L of position, that is 0. So we are comparing 56 to 60. If this is less than 60 and position is greater than or equal to 0, the condition gets satisfied. We will be shifting 60 to the first index position. So you can see over here, that's the statement by which we'll be shifting the 60 to the index position 1. Now over here, we are simply copying the value of the 0th index into the index 1. So you can see we have copied the value from the 0th index to the index 1. So both the index at 0 and 1 will have the same value at this point. And the value of position, the variable position, has turned minus 1. This is because we are decrementing the variable position by 1. So it was 0, now it became minus 1. So the next time the loop goes, the loop will terminate because the value of position is not greater than or equal to 0. So the loop will terminate, and outside the loop we have the statement as L of position plus 1 is equal to number. So the value of position is minus 1. So minus 1 plus 1, that is 0. So we are storing at the 0th index the number that is stored in the variable number, that is 56. So 56 will be stored at the 0th index. you can see the pointer has now moved to the second index. That's because the value of I has now become 2 because the while loop got terminated. So the I has now become 2. So we got the pointer at the index 2. Now at index 2, again the number that is L of I, that is L of 2, that is 4, that will get stored in the variable number. So number is now 4, and position, that is I minus 1, that will become 1 because I is 2, 2 minus 1, so that's the value of the position. So again there is a while loop, we will compare number is less than L of position. Now you can see L of position, that is L of 1. So we'll compare 4 and 60 and position greater than equal to 0. Now the condition gets satisfied. So we'll be shifting 60 to its right. So we'll be just copying the value at the first index to the second index. So there it is. We have copied the value 60 from the index value 1 to index value 2. And the value of position has now become 0 because we are decrementing position by minus 1. It was 1, now it became 0. Again, the while loop will work. It will go, the number that is 4 now will get compared with L of position. The value of position is 0, so that is now the number 4 will get compared with 56. It is less than, and the second condition, that is position greater than equal to 0, gets satisfied. So again, we will shift 56 from the 0th index to index value 1. So all we will do is we'll copy the value from 0th index to index 1. Now the value of position is minus 1 since it got decremented. Now the while loop will get terminated since the condition doesn't get satisfied. Outside the while loop, now we will copy the number 4 to its right position, that is the index value 0. So the number 4 will get stored in the index value 0. So you can see the number 56 and 60 has actually got shifted one position towards its right. So this is what we actually wanted to achieve. Now, and the pointer now has moved to the index value 3. So the value of I is 3 and the number is 3 and the value of position is 2. So what I will do now, I will fast track this video, and you can see the numbers getting changed. The variable I, number and position will get changed. And you can cross check it yourself. You can trace it on a paper and you can see whether the numbers are getting changed right or not. So I will fast track it and reach to the end point. So there it is, we have reached to the end point. The value of I is 9, number is 0 and position is minus 1. And you can see the numbers are sorted now. So I hope the concept of insertion sort is now very much clear to you. So if you have liked my video, do subscribe to my channel. There is a subscribe button in front of you. Click it right away. And after that, click on the bell icon so that you can get the regular notifications of my videos. Bye for now.